How were you discovered?
I was discovered by actually. Well, I started doing musicals, and I guess got discovered through YouTube, and because
like
I did
Justin Bieber.
No, not the same way. No, it was I was singing a cover, and then I got into a musical. But then after that, I wrote a song when I was 11, and I didn't know any English, so my dad helped me with the words, and then after that, we sent it to the record labels, and then they all wanted to meet, and then that kind of happened. That was like a long story, pretty short.
How is it to be a big musician and then still have to keep up with the normal teenage life?
It's not bad actually. It's like, well, I've been on this trip now for a few days. I have a test tomorrow. I haven't opened the book yet, but let's see how it goes. I really like the school and everything. I have to do that, and it's not that bad, to be honest.
Can you lick your nose?
No.
Try.
Can you?
Very nice.
No, that's definitely like that's the one thing I really would love to learn. Like, there's nothing else I would like to learn than lick my nose.
Yeah.
That'd be so dope.
Have you ever?
That'd be so dope.
Have you ever doubted in yourself?
Have I ever what?
Doubted.
Doubted what?
In yourself.
Oh like? No! Like oh yeah, okay. I think I understand that. So sorry, sometimes my English is very bad. I don't understand. So, not really. I feel pretty confident. You know, like if you're thinking this in this music thing, then maybe I'm just having fun with this. I'm not putting too much pressure on myself.
Just
having
like
fun.
Chilling on the
yeah,
stage.
Yeah, just chilling. Yeah.
Yeah. What is your favorite clothes brand?
I like this one brand. It's called Fear of God. That's probably
I don't know
my
that
favorite.
One.
No, you should Google it.
Yeah, I know Alpha Industries.
Oh yeah, that's nice. I have a jacket from it.
What is your favorite item from your merch store?
Probably the hoodie. It's the color is called peach. It's
yeah.
Like it's like a light pink, but it's not pink. Light pink, but it's not pink. And yeah, that's probably my favorite one. It has it has my face on the back.
Yeah. Have you ever given a flower to a girl who is not in the family?
Oh yeah, yeah. It was maybe a year ago. I had a crush on a girl, and then I was traveling at the moment. I think it was Valentine's Day. Yeah, I tried to call my mom if she could go get the flowers. I just send her like the money, and then she goes get the flowers, and then she puts it outside of her door,
so
by her door. Yes, it's so sweet. But then they know that didn't work because mom was working. So I googled like it was like some service that actually brings flowers home, and then I went there. I think that was pretty cool.
That's
cool.
Nice.
Pretty smooth.
Pretty smooth. Are you planning to have any shows in the future in Denmark?
Oh yeah, absolutely. This is the first thing I'm doing here. Like real thing I'm doing here ever, so you know it's I'm definitely coming back, and I'm gonna try to get my team to work on it or like as soon as possible because I want to come back as soon as possible.
Yeah, a lot of fans have been waiting for you.
Yeah, and I've been waiting for coming. I know Denmark is so close to like I've been to Finland and Sweden and Norway so many times, and I've never been to Denmark. I don't know why. It's not because of me. I would love to be here. I would love to be here all the time.
It's warmer than Finland.
Yeah, that's why.
If you had the opportunity to say something to the Danish fans, what would it be?
It's I'm gonna say all the basics. I'm gonna say that thank you for the support. It's so nice to be here, and it's I'm very excited to come here more often. You're so funny. You're so nice. I've been here for maybe 3 hours, and I've already met a lot of fans, and they're all so nice. And they all want me to say potato. That's no, it's not potato.
No,
it's
kartoffel.
Yes, that's.
Say it.
Kartoffel.
Oh, you're pretty good.
I see. But I don't know why. That's because I start thinking like, do you eat a lot of potatoes here? Because
no.
Like when I go to other countries, they don't really want me to say potato or any other food. I think it's like four different girls who asked me to say potato. So you know, I started wondering.
Can you say kvælkvælmeflu?
One more time.
Kvælkvælmeflu.
Kvælkvælmeflu. Did that mean something?
Red porridge with cream.
Oh yeah, of course, and yeah. Potato. You know, that's all you need to know when you're in Denmark.
Can you say three things that you hate about what people do, like in the public or when you see them?
Or like fans or?
Yeah, fans or people you just see in public.
Oh yeah. Or do you mean like as an artist? Like
yeah.
Okay. Well, I hate when people take, you know, especially when I'm at home. If I go like to, when I go, I don't go very often. But when I go to the gym, I like staying at home and playing PlayStation with my friends. That, you know, it feels better, because it's nicer. But anyway, so like when they take like photos secretly and they don't, you know,
yeah.
Because that happens like, and that happens like when you walk around town like a lot, but you don't, you know that's gonna happen. But like when you're at the gym and then you're like this and they see the picture on Snapchat, that's like the worst thing.
Yeah.
Then another thing, I don't like when for example if I see like a couple and they're, you know, kissing and hugging, and you know, it makes me feel so sad because I don't have anything. Yeah, I feel so lonely. No, but I think, you know, they could tone it down a bit. Then another thing I don't like is when, there's not a lot of things I hate, except for butter and onions and flying.
Oh yeah,
I don't eat
flying,
onions.
That's...
Do you like flying?
No.
No, me neither.
Something happened to the airplane while we were going from Oslo.
Oh, nice.
Something. Water, something come down. We were all sitting.
Oh,
like,
really?
Oh my god, are we going to die?
Yeah, that's what I think every time I fly. If I die now, and I write my mom every time.
Yeah, Matilda was like, I love you.
Aww. Nice. You have nice friends.
Yeah, I do.
Yes.
What was your first thought about performing from when you were little? Like, what was the first thought about when you started?
Well, I remember I grew up really like performing. I always had like stupid shows for my family, and they said it was actually, of course I was young, but it was actually pretty annoying because every time we had someone over, mom had a friend or something, I always had like a theater or something.
Yeah.
That I was like just acting or singing, and the shows were pretty long. So you know, my first experience of performing was when I was like super young. I don't even remember it, but you know, I just one of the biggest reasons why I do music is because, you know, I like to perform, and I like to, you know, it's not you know, just like, it's not making the music that's the most fun part, it's performing.
Yeah.
I don't remember the question, but anyways.
What is the best thing about meeting your fans?
It's probably just seeing that they're, how like excited they are just seeing me, because I don't see myself as, you know, anything, you know, very special. I just see myself as myself. So it's pretty cool to see, like weird cool, I don't know, to see that people are, you know, just excited to see me.
Yeah, just like a normal teenage guy.
Yeah,
around.
No, definitely. Yeah. So that's pretty cool.
What is the weirdest thing that a fan have ever said or done to you?
Done so much weird things, like it was like, for example, my favorite fan gift so far was, and no one has to give me fan gifts. It's not like I need that or anything. It's, you know, but I got one crazy fan gift. It was a fridge, you know, a fridge,
where you,
yeah, Chris Cap. And it was stuffed with candy and everything, and it's still in my room. It's a blue fridge.
Why? You know,
because apparently I didn't have a fridge in my room, and the fans thought I should get a fridge in my
you
room.
Needed one.
And now I have, it's not a good fridge because it's very loud. You know, if you put it into the wall, it makes crazy noise.
What?
It's like, if I'm gonna keep my Coca-Cola cold, and that's the whole night, so you can't really keep anything cold there.
Are you a different person when you're with your fans than when you're with your family and friends at home?
No. Actually, that's why. Of course, I have some jokes that I throw with my friends that I can't throw with anyone else because that would be so weird. But you know, I that's probably why. Like that's what I try to be. I try to be as you know. I try to have like no filter really. I try to be like myself with everyone and
like no masks, just be
open.
Yes. Can you describe the feeling when you're up on stage?
Not really. Like it's nothing very like, you know, it's nothing, you know, very deep to explain. It's just that, you know, I have fun when I'm on stage, and that, like if someone has fun when they, you know, dance, I don't know, maybe they can explain the feeling better, but I don't know, I just have fun on stage. I really enjoy being on stage. It's nothing deeper than that.
Can you follow me on Instagram?
Oh, absolutely. What's your Instagram? Mouth to mouth, I can give you mouth to mouth, you can teach me all about mouth to mouth, I can give you mouth to mouth, you want it, I want it.